Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 Are you a nerdy senior made my bar? Oh, essentially. Trust name on fire. As a Friday, any other was. Do I send a sword in a chain? Seven year ago, him were moving one of the two said, and then a sword in a sword a chain. Name Pabos already PMC in chain. Name 20 Rabbit. Name few or three most like a show, my name. New DNC outside of a bar, her name. Then you said, you're back for me, be an answer. I could maybe be a rock, 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 better was already now pertaining to what we see. Amen.
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 Amen. Amen.
2 weeks ago, I was here, and by the grace of God, he spoke to us. And last week, he said, all that we said in the making was an introduction. The last week, 2 weeks ago, the back in the introduction, and he ever caught chapter 1.
Amen.
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 You all that can say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Yehwe adefefe ye si apriti ya. Yehwe ne say? Eh? Eh? We see community, we see last supper. Yehwe ne say? Okay, ewe di ni. Anke ewe fese wone ewe ewe tunse di bibwana. Na ade ne drew last supper anu ubi ikani. The time that you have to dine with the Lord, the King, people begin to run. People absent themselves from churches. Even when they come, they will never take part. It's because we don't know what we are missing. Amen.
Amen.
And Yamin Shay was sending for a semi mirror. Now, MBA, because to every door there is a key. Maybe I why you're asking for one. Maybe I'm asking for one, so would you have shed on him or but you don't know which side to turn it. You may never know which side to turn the key to. So the Lord says, I should bring you a key today. With which you are going to open that door.
Amen.
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 The title of the message God says, I should bring it to you is
Favor
to the King's Table. Favor to go to the King's table. This is the table that the King has set. Which King are we talking about? King Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Whenever we see the Lord's Supper,
begin
to think about the blood of Jesus, the flesh of Jesus. But it has been every month we do it. So 12 times in a year we do it. It has become like a routine. And the things that you do in a routine, you don't value it that much. That's why it's usual. Because the first Sunday of the month, yeah. And we collect a missionary offering. That's what Paul said.
And it's not Paul.
If you eat it unwealthily,
say when did Yeshua?
They bring condemnation unto you.
And the
it's all because of the mindset.
And in that time, and I'm addressing the truth.
This last supper was written by
these
people. Matthew wrote it.
Matthew.
Mark wrote it.
Mark in Sutra 1-7.
Luke wrote it.
Luke in Sutra 1-7.
And John wrote it.
John so Etra 1-7.
All of them have almost the same thing they wrote. But Paul also wrote about it.
And so Paul also Etra 1-7.
And asked something to it.
Now on the other.
Before Paul, because he said,
Paul, said,
from what I received, that's what I'm giving it to you.
And
come to think of it. Did you receive it from Mark or from
Matthew?
Or from Luke or from John?
And I said Luke and I said John.
He got it from Galatians chapter 2, verse 2.
It
was a revelation that God gave him. So, if I am here and I write something down, and I give it to my dad here, and he reads it, he has received it from me. For example, I will say, that the blue shirt will fit you.
But I say, ah, that shirt blue, a
but when he reads it, it is him to think and see. The blue shirt will fit me all right.
Blue,
but it does not match with my shoe. Hallelujah. So Paul did not depend on what Matthew, Mark, and Luke, and John wrote. He depended upon what God before to him. So today, anytime you hear about a lost
supper,
never ever run away. Because of what Paul included in his statement. Because God gave it to him. Maybe we don't understand yet. I'm going to give you a small, simple life illustration for you to see the importance of this table set before us. My story, I pick it from 2 Samuel chapter 9. When you read the story, the Bible says,
okay, Bible says,
if you are there, go with me to 2 Samuel.
First,
I read, I explain. Amen. Are you there? After everything has been done. And King Saul was dead. David was now on the throne. There was peace on every side. Say peace.
Peace.
He said unto himself, verse 1 says, is there yet anybody left in the house of Saul that I may show kindness? I'm reading from 2 Samuel chapter 9, verses 1 downwards. Amen.
Amen.
Is there anybody there left in the house of Saul that I may show him kindness for Jonathan's sake? He mentioned him there. Normally, if you are at peace, who do you think of? It's of course your friends. Your close relatives. But this time, David said, is there anybody left in